Well, folks, it is 8:30 on Sunday morning, and we are heading out from Williston, North Dakota to go check out a couple of things today. We're going to go see Glasgow, Montana. And Glasgow has just recently been named the middle of nowhere. It has a population of 3,500 people. And they say that it is the middle of nowhere because it is the one town in the lower 48 that is the furthest from any metropolitan area with a population of 75,000 or greater. So that's how they designated it, the middle of nowhere. But we are going to go make a pass through town, and then we are going to go to a place called Fort Peck, and they have a big dam down there. And so we're going to go check that out and just kind of see what things look. We've also got some weather that looks like it's headed our direction. So I don't know, we may run into some thunderstorms. We'll just have to see what we see here. Well, I'm not yet sure what little town this is, but all of these little prairie towns look so much the same along this highway they call the High Line, which is Highway 2. And it runs all the way from, I believe, Seattle to Duluth, Minnesota. Whether or not it continues on from there, I'm not sure. But I know it covers that span, that distance there. There's a lot of little reservations and little towns along here. And this is one of those places. I'm trying to find a name on it here. They didn't have a sign coming into it. Yeah, this is Poplar. You know, every once in a while I get a little goofy, and I forget, if you can see that right there on my GPS, as I zoom in on that, there it is, it says Poplar. So we're getting closer to Glasgow. But some of these little towns are really kind of neat. You know, so much of this country just looks the same from place to place to place, every mile after mile after mile. But in some odd way, it is all still beautiful to see, even though you kind of feel like you're seeing maybe the same thing over and over again. This is just another one of those places that, for whatever reason, it struck me as being interesting. Oh, Glasgow's another 72 miles. Well, we made it to Wolf Point. And it's only like 60 degrees out here. I've got all the vents and everything in my suit opened up, and it's a little cool running down the road.
Taking over this town, they should worry. But these problems aside, I think I taught you well. That we won't run, and we won't run, and we won't run. And in the winter night sky, ships are sailing, looking down on these bright blue city lights. And they won't wait, and they won't wait, and they won't wait. We're here to stay, we're here to stay, we're here to stay. Howling ghosts, they reappear in mountains that are stacked with fear. But you're a king and I'm a lion heart, a lion heart. Far away, the far away.
Well, that sign said Glasgow, 2 miles. And it's kind of an interesting thing, because when you think about a place that's considered the middle of nowhere, you don't think of a place that's going to have a tractor dealership and a Ford dealership and all the stuff that this has. It's a relatively well-developed town along the route. And so, just to paraphrase, some dude called up all his drinking buddies and wanted to find an official answer to what the middle of nowhere was and where it was. So they sat down with their calculators and did some intense figuring, and they came up with this place. And so there was news articles and all kinds of stuff. And so, sitting out here in the middle of a sea of prairie, this that you are seeing is truly the middle of nowhere. Welcome to Glasgow, Montana. And I better get some gas before I head down to the lake. We're going to go down and check out Fort Peck next. And I didn't do a whole lot of research on it, so I'm not real sure what to expect. I know there's a dam down there. I'm not sure if there's a town or not. I'm going to want to find some place for lunch. But I think what I'll do is I'll pull in here to this Conoco and I'll ask a few questions, see what I can find out about it.
These days, where the lights don't move and the colors don't fade, leaves you empty with nothing but dreams. In a world gone shallow, in a world gone mean. Sometimes there's things a man cannot know. Gears won't turn and the leaves won't grow. There's no place to run and no gasoline. And engine won't turn and the train won't leave.
I was looking at the lake on the map, and it is a huge lake. So what we're looking at here is obviously just a very small portion of it. But even for this small portion, you look out there and you just know, boy, that is a big lake. A big old crane barge. I don't think I've ever seen one of those. How cool is that?
I'll stay with you tonight. Hold you close till the morning light. The morning watches a new day rise. We'll do whatever just to stay alive. We'll do whatever just to stay alive. The thoughts of a man who lies. There is a truth and it's on our side. Dawn is coming, open your eyes. Look into the sun as a new day's rise.
Well, folks, if you want, you can pause the film and read it for yourself, but just to give it to you as short, in 1934 they dammed up the Missouri River and that created Fort Peck Lake. It's 134 miles of lake, basically. It is also part of the original route of Lewis and Clark, and it just says basically that a lot of the wildlife is the same with the exception of the bison being gone now. So there's your history lesson on Fort Peck. Let's go see what the dam looks like. You know, as I ride along here and I look at this dam, you know, I grew up in the mountains, and so I didn't really have any kind of an appreciation for the fact, well, how should I say it? I didn't have an appreciation for how much vertical change there was in the areas that I grew up. Because I'm looking at this dam here, and it's, maybe 50 feet down to the water there, and maybe 80 or 100 feet down on the low side. Which means that this one dam, really, they didn't have to build it up very high at all to dam up 134 miles of river, which is really pretty amazing to me. It just kind of tells you how flat this ground is out here anyway. It doesn't take a whole lot of dam. You know, back home, a lot of the places that I think about a dam, and I'm thinking about something that's 200, 300, 400 feet tall, just the dam portion of it, you know, and the lake that it creates is really deep. I don't know what the depth is on this lake, but I'm guessing by the size of the dam and the surrounding terrain that it probably isn't much more than 100, maybe 150 feet deep at any point in there. I'll have to look it up.
where the lines don't move and the colors don't fade. Leaves you empty with nothing but dreams. In a world gone shallow, in a world gone mean. But there is a truth and it's on our side. Dawn is coming, open your eyes. Look into the sun as a new day's rise.
Sure doesn't look like there's much water coming out of there, but it adds up to being a hell of a lot down on the other side. I mean, this is the Missouri River we're talking about. This thing flows clear to the Mississippi River. Goes through multiple states. It's a big river. It comes together with the Yellowstone River over in Williston, North Dakota.
Time to time.